Greetings and good morning, everybody. What's up? What's going on? As you guys can see, it's Charles with the motherfucking two dude. I just woke up. We're going to some estate sales today, and I'm actually running a little bit later than I would like because I've been setting up a GoPro because I feel like this is the only way I can actually record what goes down at certain like thrift venues and resale marketplaces per se. So yeah, I'm gonna rock this in this estate sale. Hopefully, man, the battery charges in time. If not, then I'll cut this whole part out. But yeah, dude, without further ado, let's get to some estate sales, some thrifts today, and see what scores we can dig up in the trenches. Thank you to everyone shopping on the website. That's where all this stuff that I find in today's video will be listed. Without further ado, let's get it.
All two moms in the building.
Let's go.
All right, guys, welcome to my mind in an estate sale. I gotta find the master bedroom. That's goal number one. I see someone in the back bedroom grabbing grails, so I have to make that quick right. And I'm in here.
What's happening, man? What's happening?
In the neighborhood,
man. Always. Always.
All right, so right now I'm just rummaging through the tees trying to find ones that are heat.
I know
I see someone already grabbed that thing, man. I was like, dang.
I was like,
yeah, that was the first piece I saw.
I was like, whoever. Here,
I know, but hopefully I can get at least something for the man cave. You feel me?
Yeah, there's some posters
and out there. Yeah, the t-shirt. Yeah, I saw the posters and the helmet. I'm like, I'm gonna grab something for the man cave.
Yeah, that one last week was crazy, bro.
Yeah, that one was nuts. Did you get, what'd you grab? You got some stuff?
I got the Michael Jackson, man. That's what I really wanted.
Oh, that the frame photo?
No, the Michael Jackson shirt.
Oh, they had a shirt in there? Oh, yeah, I remember seeing
that. I was wondering, it wasn't all that.
What's up?
I thought I was
urgent. Oh, yeah, come on in, man. Hey, there was a cowboy sweater in here, praise God. I need that dude who got that cowboy jacket. I'm about to buy it off him.
Him behind you? He's right behind you in the closet.
Oh, you got the cowboy jacket?
Yes.
What you want for it, bro?
Come on.
I didn't see what size it is.
I thought we were early. Shit.
Yeah, I might need you to hold up that jacket once you get your hands free. I'm trying to see what that looks like, man. That's a beautiful piece.
So the homie Forrest, man, grab one of the grails, man. Dallas Cowboys full leather jacket, quarterback club. Dude, I actually have the quarterback club hat. That is crazy. White hits, kind of a Shamu leather colorway going on right there. Signed. Look at that interior. Oh, my Lord. Nice satin Dallas, big star on the back. Lord have mercy. You don't need a telescope to see that. I'll tell you that much. That thing is beautiful. And then couple more, man. My bad, bro. Dallas Cowboys sweater, and then the starter that goes harder. Is this the one? No, it doesn't have the big stars on the sleeve, but star on the back, S on the neck. This is what I love, man. Yo, Cowboys fan, LSU fan. I got a bunch of Tabasco tees, but Middle East sport, all embroidered. No cutting corners on the thread count. Crazy, man. LSU as well. That is a wild find.
Hey, these Reeboks are clean.
I like them.
I'm gonna have to get one of those t-shirts made.
I got a name for you.
What?
One other of my customers, I'm like, told me that I should sell them. I'm like, who's gonna buy a two mom shirt?
Yeah. Shoot, someone might not. But I will.
How are you doing, bud?
That's a cool hat.
I like this one. I have one of those. It's a cute cowboy's hat, isn't it?
Yeah, a little camo.
Yeah.
Your head will just disappear with that on.
You gotta
be careful.
Hey, low key, guys. Snapback cover chair, jackpot, Ireland, luck of the Irish. Let's get it.
Dang, these belts are unreal.
Oh, unreal.
Do I need this?
Oh, yes, you do.
I saw this in the picture. I was like, man.
You going to the other one after this one?
I don't know where I'm going.
It's not through here, is it?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Only God knows where I'm going after this. Dang, this is a cool poster. Any hash?
Hey, you blessed me last week, I'm gonna bless you this week.
Sure.
That second one's pretty sick.
Come on, man, grab like one of these. You can.
No, I'm good. I'm not even a Cowboy fan, though. For
real. Dude, I have this one in black and I wear it all the time.
There you go.
Thank you, bro.
No problem.
Okay, listen. Dang, that is a cool picture right here.
The bedroom.
Hey, you see these?
No, what are those?
They're Christmas lights.
That's cool.
That's cool.
I was thinking about getting that, but I'm like, I don't know if I need all that stuff.
Yeah, it's if you touch it, it's like real. It looks like
it's thin. Yeah, but that's lights behind it.
Yeah, it's like a ornament, like a decoration.
Look at this. This is fully knit.
Is it really?
Yeah.
It sure is, man.
Got that mohawk.
All right, guys. There are a couple more T-shirts in here. I had to switch off the GoPro mode because my battery's not super well charged, but I got a Jack Daniel's World Championship Barbecue 1991. I thought that was cool. For my mom, yes, I'm spoiling your Christmas surprises. Bahamas Flamingo Beach Club. All these are single stitch tees. Texas A&M, I'm a Longhorns fan, but you know, I can't pass up some crazy vintage when I see it. Dallas Cowboys, you have two polos. You got the Guinness. All embroidered, lovely day for a Guinness, toucan, and then the fall leaves, right in time, baby. This double necked vintage crew neck, need it. So we got Hidden Bins in the building again, man. Look, you got the bugs, the mud bugs, man. 1992 crawfish fest. Dude is angry. He looks like one of those crawfish that right before you're about to put them in the pot will like climb out. What you got right here? No Sweat, Dallas Cowboys, 1998, Wichita Falls, that's a crisper. Ooh, the Harley Davidson, proud to be an American right there. Yes, sir. Dude, those are sick. Oh, LSU, baseball. Yeah, that is a clean design, though. Like I'm telling you, man, the t-shirt designs just are insane. The croc hunting the crabs. Oh, is that a pillowcase or a flag?
It's a pillowcase.
Bro, Budweiser pillowcase. My lord. There are some cool finds in this house. That's why we had to pull up out here, man. We had to come out the way for these things. Hey, yeah, Ash blessed me. He blessed me with some hats in the past. Blessed me with this Dallas Cowboys 40th anniversary 1999 t-shirt as well. Got blessed in the garage with two ice cold vintage Budweisers. I'm wearing a Budweiser jacket that I thrifted, so this is just absolutely perfect. Handfuls of stuff. A couple more hats. This Albuquerque 1990 is crazy with the pins. But yeah, we'll cash out. And then I'll show you guys everything that I grabbed. All right, guys, and we are out of there. We have cashed out, and the difference is astounding when you have a vehicle to get to estate sale. So yesterday I had a skate to an estate sale because my girl took my vehicle to work and accidentally took all the keys to her car, and the van is in the shop. So I had a skate to an estate sale, busting my butt. So if you guys follow me on Instagram, you saw all that. But I mean, we have a huge haul, 25 upper body garments, a bunch of vintage hats. Hopefully you guys did get a good look with the GoPro. The only thing is that the jacket might have been covering it up and it might have been at a slightly wrong angle. I want to get into all these shirts. Y'all can see I just got a ton of single stitch vintage bangers. However, it'll take a while and everything is packed up and folded. So I'm gonna wait till the end of the video till we get home to display all of these finds. But literally this one stop is enough to constitute an entire video in and of itself, because this estate sale was so nuts. All right, guys, and we are back. First and foremost, check the fit. I found this awesome Hot Stuff Tabasco tee. I don't know, I was gonna sell it, but there's so much stuff in there that I wanted to keep. And then dude, the Albuquerque 1990 vintage trucker, also extremely tough. Okay, I don't even know what to get into first. I guess we'll just do the hats real quick, like, and then we'll get into the t-shirts. Now, I want to tell y'all, I did go to another estate sale, and unfortunately, I was recording at the wrong time, but I found an old school 90s camcorder all up in there, so I grabbed that dude, obviously. And then I went to a garage sale, and they had absolutely nothing. I just went through piles of clothes and found nothing. But hopefully y'all did enjoy the GoPro footage that I did capture at the first spot. But nevertheless, man, I grabbed this dude off the chair, the Lions Club Vintage Corduroy Snapback. Nice little golden rope belt on the top of the brim. So I thought that was really cool. I also grabbed this. This definitely needs to be clean, man. So a lot of these items will be available, if not today, then tomorrow. I kind of got to see what my schedule's looking like, but this hat definitely needs to be rasterized. It's very stained up, but it is Skagway, Alaska, the great land. Beautimous. Now I got this Coors Brewery. So this guy liked Budweiser and I guess Coors as well. This is another hat that definitely needs a good little cleaning to it, but the amount of puffed up embroidery is just tantalizing. Then you have the Ireland hat. You guys saw this, but it does have a nice little back hit on the bootay. And then I was blessed with these Cowboys hats. Thank you so much to my boy Neto, the Hidden Ben. Again, 1998 Dallas Cowboys hat. This one is so, so clean. I love when the hats are all tatted up. Look at the back of this dude. Now, I did just feel the snaps crumble a little bit, so it is missing a little bit of the back snap, but it still will close. These aren't going to be for sale, man. They were gifted, and I'm a Cowboys fan, so you already know what time it is. And then you have the leather rendition as well. Very shiny, sparkling. Got the nice little star on one side, NFL branded on the other. And this one has a good shape to it still. So very pleased with those hats. Now, I did also grab this art piece. I went in the bedroom and I did record, but I just felt like that clip didn't really fit in the flow of the video. But this is a cool little multicolored piece that definitely kind of matches this background aesthetic. So I grabbed this dude to hang up. Nice little piece of art. Okay, now we're getting into what you guys really haven't seen, and that is the content of all the t-shirts and polos and crew necks that I grabbed. So let's go ahead and bum rush through these dudes. Nice little Grand Slam vintage little golf tennis polo right here, colorway crazy. I got this vintage Mardi Gras. Look at that logo, man. So colorful, so nice. This is a crew neck. Now, one of the grails was this nice Super Bowl 20 and what? It's 28. It's Super Bowl 28. But it's this back-to-back Super Bowl champions, Dallas Cowboys. This is another piece, man. It says XL. If this fits me stupid, I'll sell it. But if not, y'all already know I'm keeping this bad boy. I'm sorry. A lot of the stuff in today's video, it just struck my fancy. Like, what can I say? You have this leaf-covered crew neck, which I showed off. This is a vintage 1994 crew neck. It just has like a little crest. Very, very soft, very nice medieval steez. And then this dude was from Louisiana, so he had a lot of that Tabasco gear, such as this amazing Pepper Paradise Tabasco Louisiana license plate tee. Very cool. And all these t-shirts are single stiatch. So y'all saw this. My homie got one, and yet I have another.
Another one.
The Cajun Riviera. You got that gator hunting the crabs. Very nice. Just a ton of clean white tees. I got the guy Harvey Fishes Get You Hella Biatches t-shirt right here. This one is new school 2003 LSU national champion t-shirt right there. And then this dude, man, the Mud Bug, the Crawl Daddy. You gotta love yourself some Louisiana merch right here. This is very, very hard. Pinch them tails and suck them heads. Oh man, very cool, very clean. And then there was this really nice Commerce, Texas, man. You have this like annual Boys de Art Capital of the World tee. You got these little like, Osage oranges, I think that's what they're called, playing instruments all up on there. Very clean graphic. And then a nice little pink, man. Looking like some salmon, baby. Another Mardi Gras tee. You guys can see it's laced with that gold. You saw the Cowboys polos right here. This stack is just so tall. Y'all also saw the Flamingo tee, A&M, Cowboys, Guinness, and then you also have the banging Jack Daniels t-shirt. Now, last but not least, one shirt that I didn't show off, but you guys might have saw in the GoPro footage, is this whole lot of Tabasco t-shirt as well. So these are just very, very clean tees, very awesome. I'm super happy with all the things that I did get. That estate sale was crazy. So shout out to moms once again for letting me record up in there and just have a good time, man. I saw a lot of friendly faces in the sale, and I appreciate all you guys for supporting and watching the videos at home. Hopefully y'all did enjoy this one. I will do some more GoPro footage as I see fit, especially on like half off days and more competitive like thrift environments or whatever the case may be. But stay tuned, live the dream, eat that ice cream. Link in description to my website. Check it out. That is the best way to support me and to upgrade your wardrobe. All right, I'll catch y'all next time. I'm locked, I'm loaded, and I'm out. Peace. Like the video. Killing these songs, leaving a bloody life I roost. And I'm in it to win it, so I'm somebody that you should get.